By Real Life Lore, sponsored by The Great Courses Plus. A little over 3 months ago, I released a video about what if everybody on Earth lived inside the same city. Today, we're going to talk about something perhaps even more terrifying. What if everybody on Earth lived inside the same building? How large would this building have to be to house all 7.4 billion of us alive right now? It's not as strange of a question as it may seem at first. This picture right here is the town of Whittier, Alaska, and by that I mean that the entire town is located inside of this one building. The entire city's population of 214 people, for the most part, lives inside this single building, and they really don't have to ever leave it. This is because almost all of the functions that you would normally find inside of a city are all located inside of the building. Inside, you can find the city's police department, the post office, the mayor's office, a general store, a grocery store, a hospital, a laundromat, a hotel, a church in the basement, and even an indoor playground complete with a swimming pool. The building is the city, and the residents of the city can stay indoors almost indefinitely whenever the weather begins to get bad because all of the city's services as well as their homes are all located inside of it. But even still, just 214 people live here, which is nowhere near the entire human race, so let's get bigger and think about buildings with the largest seating capacity. The AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas is the home of the Dallas Cowboys and is truly enormous, larger than the US Capitol building and capable of seating 80,000 people, which means that you could comfortably seat the entire population of Andorra inside of it. But it still isn't as big as the largest indoor stadium in the world, which is located here in Pyongyang, North Korea, and is called Rungrado 1st of May Stadium. It has the capacity to seat 114,000 people all indoors, 34,000 more people than the AT&T Stadium, or about the same population as the island of Kiribati, or about 20% of the population of Wyoming. But even that isn't as big as the largest ever planned indoor stadium, which would have been constructed in Berlin by Nazi Germany had they won the Second World War. The building would have been called the Volkshall, and would have been capable of seating 180,000 people inside, about 5% of the population of modern-day Berlin. The building would have been so enormous that German architects calculated that the moisture collected by all of these people breathing inside of it could have actually created artificial rain inside, causing the building to have its own weather. If we move to outdoor stadiums, however, which would still be one building in a sense, then we can fit much more people. The largest outdoor stadium currently is the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, capable of seating 235,000 people, a little less than the entire population of Reno, Nevada. But once again, the Nazis had plans for an even larger stadium in the event of a victory in World War II. Their plans were to construct the Deutsches Stadion in Nuremberg, which would have been capable of seating a massive 405,000 people. More than the population of New Orleans and over 5 times the seating capacity of the AT&T Stadium. Hitler planned that after Germany won World War II, every single Olympic Games for the rest of history would take place here at this stadium. But because the war was lost, the stadium was never finished. However, the largest building anywhere in the world in terms of how many people are meant to fit inside of it would be the Great Mosque in Mecca, Saudi Arabia. During the Hajj period, the mosque has the capacity to fit 4 million people inside of it, which is greater than the entire population of Panama. There are buildings that could, in theory, fit more people than this, though. They're not designed to fit people, but we're going to see what could happen if we did so anyway. Before we get started with this part, though, let's figure out how many people we could safely fit inside of 1 square meter. After a lot of research, it seems that anything over 5 people per square meter could be potentially dangerous and lead to people trampling each other. So, at the highest limit, let's go with about 5 people on average being able to possibly fit into 1 square meter. The largest building in the world in terms of its physical footprint on the Earth's surface is going to be the Tesla Gigafactory once it's finished being built in Nevada. It's gargantuan when compared to the AT&T Stadium and the US Capitol building, and it would take up a physical space of 530,000 square meters, or a little larger than Vatican City, which means that you could fit the world's smallest country completely inside of the boundaries of the world's largest building. At 5 people per square meter, that means that you could fit 2,650,000 people inside the building all indoors, more people than live in all of Namibia. So we're at the scale of entire countries worth of people fitting inside one building now, but we can still get much larger. The largest building ever designed in terms of the floor space that it would occupy was the Crystal Island building, which would have been built in Moscow were it not halted. Had it have been completed, it would have possessed 2.5 million square meters worth of floor space, which combined could have fit a staggering 12,500,000 people, or more than the entire population of Belgium. But we can still go even bigger if we begin to take a 3-dimensional view view rather than the two-dimensional view that we've had so far. With this in mind, the average height for a modern human is roughly 1.63 meters. Therefore, if we construct a cube with a 1 square meter base and a height of 1.63 meters, then we could fit 5 average humans inside of it. This gives us 0.326 cubic meters per person, or 3.07 people per cubic meter. With this math in mind, the largest building in the world in terms of sheer volume is the Boeing Everett factory located in Washington. The building possesses 13.3 million cubic meters located entirely indoors, which is so large that the building has its own microclimate somewhat similar to what the proposed Volkshalle in Berlin would have been like. Adding floors into the building with an average height of just 1.63 meters each, capable of fitting the average human inside, and we could theoretically fit 40,831,000 people inside of here, which would be enough to fit the entire populations of Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Iceland, Greenland, Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania all combined, and still have room left over for all of Serbia just for good measure. That's the largest building in the world, though, and that's still not even 1% of the entire human population that could possibly fit inside of it. To get to that point, we need to construct a new building, and if we did so, what is the smallest possible size that it could be to fit all of us? Well, at the time of making this video, the world population is currently 7.478 billion people. If we crammed people into the same density as we did inside the Boeing factory, then we would require a volume of 2.436 billion cubic meters, or 2.436 cubic kilometers. The building would be a cube with sides of 1.346 kilometers in length and a height of 1,346 meters. This seems big, but placed in downtown New York City, it would actually look like this, inside of which you can actually fit every single human being alive today. The tallest building in the world is the Burj Khalifa at nearly 830 meters high, but the tallest building under construction that will be done in 2020 is the Jeddah Tower, which will be much higher when finished at 1,008 meters. Only 338 meters short of our mega cube. The base of the cube would only be about 5 times larger than the Tesla Gigafactory as well, so building the cube is certainly within the realm of possibility. And if it was built, the entire human race alive today, all 7.478 billion of us, could all fit inside of a building that would only take around half an hour to jog around. So thank you very much for watching this video. I must now take the time to thank my incredible sponsor, The Great Courses Plus. The Great Courses Plus is a subscription on-demand video learning service where you can subscribe to and watch unlimited top-notch courses that are taught by brilliant Ivy League professors, as well as experts from National Geographic, the Smithsonian, the Culinary Institute of America, and hundreds of other extremely qualified individuals. They offer an unlimited access to thousands of different lectures over pretty much anything that you could possibly ever be interested in. If you enjoyed the video that you just watched, then I would strongly recommend the lectures on population growth that are a part of their economics and finance courses. They are fascinating subjects and honestly helped a lot with the production of this video. You can watch these or hundreds of other courses completely for free when you sign up for a 30-day free trial using the link on your screen now. www.thegreatcoursesplus.com/reallifelore, or you can click on the link in the description. If you enjoyed the video that you just watched, then I hope that you'll subscribe to my channel by clicking here. You can visit my Patreon by clicking here, watch some older videos of mine by clicking over here on the left, and I'll look forward to seeing you again for the next new video soon. With that in mind, the largest building in the world in terms of sheer volume is the Boeing Everett factory located in Washington. The building possesses 13.3 million cubic meters located entirely indoors, which is so large that the building has its own microclimate somewhat similar to what the proposed Volkshalle in Berlin would have been like. Adding floors into the building with an average height of just 1.63 meters each, capable of fitting the average human inside, and we could theoretically fit 40,831,000 people inside of here, which would be enough to fit the entire populations of Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Iceland, Greenland, Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania all combined, and still have room left over for all of Serbia just for good measure. That's the largest building in the world, though, and that's still not even 1% of the entire human population that could possibly fit inside of it. To get to that point, we need to construct a new building, and if we did so, what is the smallest possible size that it could be to fit all of us? Well, at the time of making this video, the world population is currently 7.478 billion people. If we crammed people into the same density as we did inside the Boeing factory, then we would require a volume of 2.436 billion cubic meters, or 2.436 cubic kilometers. The building would be a cube with sides of 1.346 kilometers in length and a height of 1,346 meters. This seems big, but placed in downtown New York City, it would actually look like this, inside of which you can actually fit every single human being alive today. The tallest building in the world is the Burj Khalifa at nearly 830 meters high, but the tallest building under construction that will be done in 2020 is the Jeddah Tower, which will be much higher when finished at 1,008 meters. Only 338 meters short of our mega cube. The base of the cube would only be about 5 times larger than the Tesla Gigafactory as well, so building the cube is certainly within the realm of possibility. And if it was built, the entire human race alive today, all 7.478 billion of us, could all fit inside of a building that would only take around half an hour to jog around. So thank you very much for watching this video. I must now take the time to thank my incredible sponsor, The Great Courses Plus. The Great Courses Plus is a subscription on-demand video learning service where you can subscribe to and watch unlimited top-notch courses that are taught by brilliant Ivy League professors, as well as experts from National Geographic, the Smithsonian, the Culinary Institute of America, and hundreds of other extremely qualified individuals. They offer an unlimited access to thousands of different lectures over pretty much anything that you could possibly ever be interested in. If you enjoyed the video that you just watched, then I would strongly recommend the lectures on population growth that are a part of their economics and finance courses. They are fascinating subjects and honestly helped a lot with the production of this video. You can watch these or hundreds of other courses completely for free when you sign up for a 30-day free trial using the link on your screen now. www.thegreatcoursesplus.com/reallifelore, or you can click on the link in the description. All in Berlin would have been like. Adding floors into the building with an average height of just 1.63 meters each, capable of fitting the average human inside, and we could theoretically fit 40,831,000 people inside of here, which would be enough to fit the entire populations of Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Iceland, Greenland, Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania all combined, and still have room left over for all of Serbia just for good measure. That's the largest building in the world though, and that's still not even 1% of the entire human population that could possibly fit inside of it. To get to that point, we need to construct a new building, and if we did so, what is the smallest possible size that it could be to fit all of us? Well, at the time of making this video, the world population is currently 7.478 billion people. If we crammed people into the same density as we did inside the Boeing factory, then we would require a volume of 2.436 billion cubic meters, or 2.436 cubic kilometers. The building would be a cube with sides of 1.346 kilometers in length and a height of 1,346 meters. This seems big, but placed in downtown New York City, it would actually look like this, inside of which you can actually fit every single human being alive today. The tallest building in the world is the Burj Khalifa at nearly 830 meters high, but the tallest building under construction that will be done in 2020 is the Jeddah Tower, which will be much higher when finished at 1,008 meters. Only 338 meters short of our mega cube. The base of the cube would only be about 5 times larger than the Tesla Gigafactory as well, so building the cube is certainly within the realm of possibility. And if it was built, the entire human race alive today, all 7.478 billion of us, could all fit inside of a building that would only take around half an hour to jog around. So thank you very much for watching this video. I must now take the time to thank my incredible sponsor, The Great Courses Plus. The Great Courses Plus is a subscription on-demand video learning service where you can subscribe to and watch unlimited top-notch courses that are taught by brilliant Ivy League professors, as well as experts from National Geographic, the Smithsonian, the Culinary Institute of America, and hundreds of other extremely qualified individuals. They offer an unlimited access to thousands of different lectures over pretty much anything that you could possibly ever be interested in. If you enjoyed the video that you just watched, then I would strongly recommend the lectures on population growth that are a part of their economics and finance courses. They are fascinating subjects and honestly helped a lot with the production of this video. You can watch these or hundreds of other courses completely for free when you sign up for a 30-day free trial using the link on your screen now. www.thegreatcoursesplus.com/reallifelore, or you can click on the link in the description. If you enjoyed the video that you just watched, then I hope that you'll subscribe to my channel by clicking here. You can visit my Patreon by clicking here, watch some older videos of mine by clicking over here on the left, and I'll look forward to seeing you again for the next new video soon.